It's grandma's birthday party, and it's a rocking party.
Oh, yeah. You get your house back, you get your dog back, you get your best friend Jackson back, you get your truck back, you get your hair back, you get your first and second jobs back, your front porch swing going daily. And a diamond ring. And a boat in a Harley.
That old black cat named Charlie.
Sounds a little crazy. Yeah. A little scattered and absurd.
Yeah. That's what you get when you play a country song backwards.
I'm really excited about a lot of things about this movie. I get to make a cameo, I get to perform.
We're gonna slow it down for this next song, if that's all right.
Oh my gosh, I cannot say enough about Taylor Swift. I never gone
with the wind. She's so talented and gorgeous and sweet as can be, so we were happy to have her on our set.
Taylor contributed a song called Crazier, which she wrote herself.
I wrote the song Crazier when I was 13, and so this song is really a reflection of what I thought love was supposed to be. And, you know, sometimes you write a love song about what you hope will find you and what you hope you'll find someday, not about what you're actually going through. You lift my feet off the ground, you spin me around, you make me crazier. I wrote the song in hopes that possibly it would be in the movie, but I never thought that it would be such a big, prominent song. It's absolutely one of the most exciting things. This song is playing when the main characters of the movie, Miley and Billy Ray, they're both falling in love with that song as a background. It's really cool to have that kind of a part in the movie.
I like this idea of a song that taught a dance, that taught a song, that taught a dance, and the result was the Hoedown Throw.
It's Miley's Macarena, where Miley jumps on the stage and leads the audience through this incredible sequence of dance moves. Pop it, lock it, polka dot it, country fighting, hip hop it, put your hawk in the sky, move side to side, jump to the left, stick it, glide.
The Hoedown Throwdown. You know, Miley was incredible. She came in, she probably picked it up within an hour or so, maybe even less than that. I was impressed.
Because I've been dancing for so long, like, I pick it up, I have, like, one of those photographic memories, so I'm, like, recording it, and then to remember, I don't know how I do it. Pop it, lock it, polka dot it, country fighting, hip hop it. But everyone else, I'm like, sorry, Lucas, but when he does the polka dot, I crack up every time. It's like the whole room would be shaking like he's doing it, so it's so funny.
I felt like I was doing an 80s workout video. I'm having a tough time with it, but I'll get it eventually, so it's pretty fun to dance to.
And then I gotta watch Jason, and Jason's just so silly. He's like, I can't dance, so I might as well make people laugh, so it's great.
Jamal he's an amazing choreographer, but he is much better in person than he is on the DVD, because we got little DVDs where he teaches us the dance.
I had to learn it watching it on TV, and I felt ridiculous in my trailer doing this by myself.
Oh, man. I didn't know. So, I mean, it looks really, really low budget.
Hey everybody, this is the Hoedown Throwdown instructional video.
And it looks like he's doing it in like a 4-foot by 4-foot cell. I mean, there's no room. He's doing all these moves up into the wall, and funny is funny.
But from what I understand, everybody learned it from this DVD, and it's like the hot stuff right now, you know. I wanted the audience to feel like if I learn this, I'll probably be really good at it, and I'll probably look good doing it. And it's simple enough for everybody to participate.
At some point, everyone will have to do the Hoedown Throwdown.
I've seen a lot of the dancers doing the Hoedown Throwdown, but I took one look at that and said, that ain't my cup of tea. Let the dancers dance and the singers sing. That's my motto. Throw it all together, that's how we roll.
Up next, we'll take you back to the set of Hannah Montana the Movie for the performance that had the entire cast and crew in tears. Don't go away.
Caterpillar in a tree, how you wonder who you'll be.
Your daddy used to say that to you every night.
Not so much anymore.
Miley's doing some of her finest work to date in this film. I'm so proud of her, not only as a daddy and in her personal life, but as a musician, to see the kind of songs that she writes and inspiration that she brings musically.
I've been in the business for a long, long time and worked with an incredible variety of talent. And I gotta say, in all my years, I mean, this is one special artist. It's an amazing thing just to be around her and watch it.
The show really has become this global phenomenon.
When they see this film, I think they're going to be blown away.
I didn't want a film in which the story stopped, the song happened, and then the story restarted. I wanted a film in which the story was helped by the song and actually pushed along by the song.
It's a great combination of a heartfelt family movie with some beautiful music and some fantastic performances.
Fans take away just believing in themselves a little bit more, because that's what it's all about, and I hope they just feel inspired. And no matter what, it's not about how you get there or when you get there, but it's about the journey.
The songs are more powerful than our words, and I think that's so cool. A movie can be lifted up by music.
I hope you're enjoying this inside look into Hannah Montana the movie. You know, the story's all about taking a journey. And like Miley says in the film, life's a climb, but the view's great. Miley sings the perfect song to help tell the story. And I think it's one of the best songs ever. Check it out. Here's the climb.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it.
Miley sings this awesome song called The Climb, which is just amazing. It's so pretty.
Make feels lost with no direction. My faith is
it's about what Miley Stewart, Hannah Montana, is working towards. It's becoming a better person and realizing the greater picture and the things that are really important.
Keep my head held high.
Miley's performance of it gives you chills, because she has never sung a song like this.
Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose.
It's all about following your dreams and never giving up. Faith and hope and love, you know, that's what life's about and what the world needs to hear right now.
It's the climb.
I hope when they walk away from the movie, they feel like they've been to my home. Just, there's a couple things that I hope they see and they like and they think are, you know, fun, because they were fun for us.
Sometimes I knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking.
I'm proud to have made a genuinely family movie about the things that are important.
I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just gotta keep going. And
I think country music is all about storytelling, and I think The Climb does a good job of that. It shows that it's not all about the destination, it's more about the journey. It's a very inspirational song.
There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. And sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's a climb.
When a family comes to see the Hannah Montana film, I hope that they can relate to it and take something away from it that they can put in their own heart of hearts. Well, I hope that you had fun watching the behind the scenes of Hannah Montana the movie. Don't forget the soundtrack comes out on March 24th and the movie hits theaters on April the 10th. Y'all take care. We'll see you at the show.